for. These are the mean streets of Columbus, Georgia. My name is Lieutenant Frank Drebin. I'm a private investigator, specializing in missing persons, cheating spouses, and people who forget to pay their bar tab. There'd been a recent wave of gorgeous fashion models found naked and lying unconscious in laundromats on the west side. Unfortunately, I had to go back to the office and find a new assistant, a new secretary. My first appointment was already there. Good afternoon. How you doing, pal?
I'm well, sir. And you?
Another day in paradise.
I know what you mean.
So you're here to apply for the office assistant position?
Yes, sir. As you will see from my resume, I'm very skilled in managing an office.
Let me see what you got there.
Here you are.
Nice.
This looks terrific. Just terrific. I will file this one with the others. Would you like a smoke?
No, thank you.
Cigar?
Yes, I know. The last guy I worked with smoked pipes.
Nothing like a good cigar.
Do you smell something burning?
What? I offered you one.
Lord in heaven.
So, why don't you just tell me about yourself?
Well, I worked in the United Kingdom, where I teamed up with another detective there.
That's
on
it?
Baker
Street. Just a detective?
For a private investigator, then. We went on some very dangerous adventures. Whew, I tell you what. That guy only took the hardest cases. Stuff that even Scotland Yard couldn't solve. Are you sure you don't smell smoke? After that guy shot me, I figured it was time to get out and move back to the States where it's quieter. So, as I was saying...
Listening to this guy was like eating a spoonful of Drano. Sure, it will clean you out, but it will leave you hollow on the inside. Why was he in England? I think he fell hard for his last boss.
It's like you're not even paying attention. Let's be honest, I really think your office is on fire.
Look, everything looks great. Let me get back to you. I'll give you a call. We'll be in touch. Sounded much more promising over the phone. That delicately beautiful face and a body that could melt a cheese sandwich from across the room and breasts that seemed to say, "Hey, look at these." She was the kind of woman who made you want to drop to your knees and thank God you were a man. She reminded me of my mother, all right. No doubt about it. Please, come in and have a seat.
Oh, thank you.
Look, tits. I mean, toots.
Why don't I just give you my resume?
Super.
Mm-hmm.
Her resume was pretty much blank. I could tell she'd been up all morning working on it. This is quite impressive.
Mm-hmm.
It was obvious she needed to get out of the house. I could tell the kid needed a break.
Thank you, sir.
What?
You know I can hear you, right?
Damn it, talking out loud again.
Well, yeah, I thought that you knew that.
The dame was obviously crazy. She was hearing voices in her head. I like that. Well, it's this condition I got, see? It makes me blurt out things. Let me get straight to the point. Why should I hire you?
Well, see, mister. I've got two kids eating dog kibble at home and my husband's lost at sea. Do you know what it's like to be married to a man for 14 years? And all of a sudden, he's dead?
No, I can't say that I do. I did live with a guy once, but that was just for a couple years. Usual slurs, innuendos, rumors. I ran that guy out of town like a regular leper. Let me ask you a few questions. How are you at answering the phone? You can answer the phone.
Oh, right? Yeah. I talk to everybody. I talk to you. I talk to everyone. I love talking. Talking's my favorite.
Can you take memos? Do you know shorthand?
What shorthand? I know longhand.
Call it what you will. A hunch. A woman's intuition. She looked like she knew her way around an office. Look, I think you'll fit right in around here. Why don't you come back tomorrow morning about 9 a.m. and you can start work then.
Oh, thank you, mister. You won't regret it.
I think I was already. I had probably made another bad decision, but what the hell? I already had several alimony payments past due. What was one more? As she walked out of my office, I could tell this was going to be another disastrous relationship. Well, you take a chance getting up in the morning, crossing the street, or sticking your face in a fan.
Oh, hi. How are you?
Hey, I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing well.
So do you think you got the job?
Oh, yeah. He told me to show up Monday morning at 9 a.m. Yeah, I guess good looks will get you anywhere.